There have been moments, almost 2 years in the making, at international airports across the country as family and friends finally reunite. Australia's hard border policy during the pandemic, dubbed Fortress Australia by some, has now been lifted for vaccinated tourists. But even on day one, there's been no guarantee we won't close again.
It isn't a wedding without your best friend, and after four postponements, this one's made it just in time.
Oh my gosh, how many times have we tried this? So many times, and the fact that you guys opened up just in time, literally like 3 days before the wedding, is unbelievable.
I'm shaky, I'm so excited.
Australia's hard border policy kept tourists away and families apart.
Oh my gosh!
2 years is enough to not see family, even more than enough.
For some, it was longer than they can remember.
Oh, about a year and a half.
No, 2 years.
2 years, sorry.
While most arriving today were here to visit family and friends, there were the odd tourists, treated to a welcome of kangaroo toys, Tim Tams, and the one they weren't as sure about, Vegemite.
Is this why you always greet guests in Sydney? This is pretty special.
We will need all the good publicity we can get. International tourism is worth $38 billion to this state's economy alone. 300,000 jobs rely on it.
We've basically lost 80% of our revenue overnight, and at some point it was actually 100% due to the shutdowns.
The whole world is looking for the tourists we want, and Australia has to be in that mix.
But while our borders are now open, our biggest market is still missing. Chinese tourists were at number one in both spending and numbers, but their international border is expected to remain closed for most of 2022.
There's no doubt we won't get to pre-pandemic levels until all markets do reopen.
But as for whether they'll guarantee the border will remain open.
I can tell you what I can give you is a guarantee that I'll be doing everything I can to keep it open.
At least we're keeping the promise of a warm welcome and even warmer weather.
Lovely to be here. I understand the weather's even better than in Britain, and sometimes the cricket is too.
Ursula Hager for 10 News First.